Well, another day, and we're continuing on. Right where we left off, we drilled this. This is the second side, right? And we drilled it with a quarter into the counterboard area already, where the lock screw nut goes. And then we took a half-inch end mill, went in there a little bit deeper. Now we're going to go in with a half-inch drill from the tip of the drill, equal to the surface here, right? From the tip of the drill, 1 9/16. What a mess, huh? Now I'm going to go in from the surface, 1 9/16 with a half inch end mill. Now this is a longer end mill, about a 2.5 inch DOC on it. All right, so right out of the mill from doing our second drilling, boring operation. Now it says to remove the slide. Now it's just locked in there with that, and I was using the vise to hold it. So this might not want to, after doing all that drilling and boring, probably not going to want to come out of there very easily. There we go. So you can see we formed. So you can see we formed the bore here and the shoulder in here. And anyway, and the edges are sharp. Things are sharp. They deburred, but they're sharp. I'll do a little more deburring now, especially on these other edges here. Then they want us to fit the nut. Now you can see the shaft here went through that, and we bored all that away, obviously. I'm going to have to deburr these edges a little bit in here because they're pretty sharp. Now they say put this in. You're probably gonna have to deburr that edge, yep, to even get it in there. Anyway, they said to put this in here, Loctite it in, Loctite this in place, and then come back and center drill it where you lined up here. Now I can line back up. I didn't change my setup, and I used my 1-inch gauge block again, and I could center right up on it. I didn't move the mill table. That's to drill it for your threading. So I think I'll do that. Now this is going to be a 1/4 inch 40 thread. Well, I'm plumb out a 1/4 inch 40 taps. I thread stuff like that all the time. I'm going to come up with a way to thread that hole, a cross hole in this piece on the lathe. Single point it. I haven't come up with a method yet, but I'm going to. So after I get that center drilled, then I'm to bore this out, this bridge right here in the head. We'll take that away. The only bridge will be left will be in the slide. The screw, the adjusting screw, will be in there, and it'll be locked on that to move the slide back.
You're back in the mill. Now, I did not Loctite this in, but this fit very snug when I went to push it all the way in, so I tapped it in, and it's very tight, because I'm going to have to take it back out. They say to drill it with a 7/32nd, so that's what we'll do. Now I'm going to take that out and then go in and knock that bridge out. Now we're going to go back in with this half inch end mill and take that bridge out.
we're moving on to, well, here, so I have that hole in that. We're going to thread that. But now we're moving on to more work on the cross slide. We need to put in holes for tool holders to go on here, and locking screw and such. So what we're going to do is we're going to be drilling down through here in this area all the way through, and some threading for M5. So we're going to continue working on this with a cross slide.
Slide in here, sitting on a half inch parallel. I put a 1-inch gauge block. I did not move this, just in case I needed it as a reference. I put a 1-inch gauge block in there and just set this up so it's roughly in the middle. I took the edge finder against each sharp edge there and got the center. And this is my Y0 against the back of the vise already. And our reference on the drawings from this surface. So we came over 9/16 of an inch and we're now in the center. Now we're going to run a 5.1 millimeter, well, a number 7 drill for 9/16 of an inch for a clearance hole. We'll do that to each end. How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard in the shop. Back on the Hemingway kit spherical turning tool. We're trying to get the slide piece completed. So we have it, of course, it's all fitted. It's center, the bore is done here for the screw, adjusting screw. It's all milled out. We have the counter bore and tapped M5 down deep and down 9/16 of an inch deep down inside on both ends. That's for locking screws for the tool holders. Now we need to put in 2 half-inch holes. They are not very deep, 400 to 430 thousandths maximum, and half an inch of diameter. So we're going to want those holes pretty precise as far as sizing, so they're not unusually for the tool holders that you know it's half inch type of thing. So we're going to bore those holes. So we're going to go over the mill and get these two holes put in, and then a locking pin hole also. And then this piece should be done. Here's the drawing of what we're going to be doing. See if we can get that stay in focus, right? So these are the two tool holder holes. This cross hole we already have in there, and we have a pinhole to do. Those are two we're going to bore. And you can see them right here. And then we'll do that little hole also. Okay, we got the slide in there. We checked it for squareness to the jaw with one of the stand squares. So I'm happy with that. I put the gauge block in to get an even spacing in case I have to take it out for some reason. We centered up using the edge finder on each surface here, so we're center line. And our Y0 is still against the back jaw, and we came in 5/16. Yeah, since I do have a DRO and I can save locations, I'm going to save this location, come down here and do the same thing on the other end. So I moved over an inch and a half from that hole to this position. Now I'm going to open it up with a 7/16 end mill. We're at about 463 on the holes, and I just used a gauge pin to do that. So I have a couple of gauge pins here, 498.
500. I want it to be 500 to just nicely fit. So we're gonna bore these. Barely taking a little skim cut there. I made that last cut and I went all the way down, the, you know, touched in the bottom barely, but a little too much. And that's what can happen, tweak the hell out of my little end of my boring bar. Thank you to the viewer who included this and some tools one time, and this is how viewership really helps support the channel. So I do have one here I can use that will work out just fine. Fortunately, that last cut was my lat when I tweaked the boring bar, but half inch pin fits just perfect in there. That'll be just fine. All right, we're right at 498 is, it'll go if I really wanted it to. So just a touch more. Oh yeah, we might have a little burr on that hole in there, but I think that's it. I will go in if we just clean it up in there. Yeah, it'll go. Now we're 1 inch in from this end, the reference end, and in the center. Well, we're basically done with the slide. Still a little bit more when we get more final assembly going. We're going to drill, I guess, that hole a little deeper for some type of locking pin. But other than that, the slide is basically done. We'll probably do a little cleanup on top, maybe with surface grinder action, or just I'll do draw file that top so it looks a little nicer. But this is coming out really well. Really working good. So the next part is we have the tool holders to make. We have to thread this internally. We have tool holders to make, and we have the screw to make still. The screw is the very last part in the instructions. The next part are the tool holders. So stay tuned, and if you like the more content like this, please subscribe. And we'll keep her up, keep going here. This is a nice, this is a fun project.